Welcome to Wisconsin Women. We're on University Avenue at William Thomas Custom Design Jewelers. We're going to be busting some myths today, like diamonds are indestructible. Or are they? The owner, Bill Furman, is going to join us and help us talk about some of those myths. Another myth might be if you're stressed and busy, the best thing you can do is keep pushing forward. Maybe not. Our next guest is going to encourage us to take some self-care, especially in these busy, stressful times right now. Angela Keelan is a UW-Madison certified life coach. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me. Nice to see you.
So things are busy, things are stressful. We've got coronavirus and political things and the...
A lot of stress.
Climate change. So what do you think about self-care? How do you define it for us?
Well, there are a lot of definitions out there, and it has become really a buzzword in recent years, mm-hmm. primarily because the word busy has become a way of being a status symbol. Mm-hmm. How many times we hear, I'm so busy. Oh, I'd love to, but I'm so busy. I'm so busy. And
yeah.
so.
Yeah, you do hear that.
Yes, you do.
Thinking about it.
And that's where self-care comes mm-hmm. in. By definition, it means behaviors and activities that we take on a regular basis to overcome stress and enhance our well-being. Mm-hmm. And it means more than just a bubble bath or avocado toast or a superfood smoothie. It actually means taking some time to address how we're thinking, how we're being, and how busy we are.
Gosh, I love that, because I think that we need to actually have a reminder to tell us it's okay to go that level, to talk to someone too. You talked a little bit about the I'm busy trend, but what are some other self-care trends you're seeing in 2020?
Well, this might come as welcome news to people, mm-hmm. Especially in light of the COVID-19 information we're receiving and precautions we're being asked mm-hmm. to take. And that is 2020 is the year of the nap. So it's become more of a luxury to be able to take a nap because there's so much emphasis today on multitasking. Mm-hmm. The expectation is that we are to multitask. And in truth, research shows that only about 2%, 2.5% of adults can effectively multitask.
Wow.
The rest, we're all struggling to be effective in all of those areas. And what happens is people become tired, burned out, and they need a break. And so naps are becoming a way to reset.
Yay.
And they do that in other countries, and it's like a normal thing.
They do. So it's catching on more mainstream here. It's becoming more of a luxe, like I'm gonna take a quick nap.
Oh, interesting.
Yes.
I like this. Maybe that'll become the new status,
Wouldn't
right?
Wouldn't that be nice?
That would be nice.
Yeah.
And another trend that's happening, which also is probably going to be even bigger because of some of the current state of affairs, is time spent on our mental and emotional health and well-being. So working on breathing practices that calm tension or anxiety or expectations. Meditation practices mm-hmm. that allow us to release things and forgive and feel more at peace.
That's great.
And life coaches, which can help people along the way with making changes.
I like those ideas, those changes. Those are so much more real than taking the pill or taking some external thing to try to fix the stress, I guess.
More natural.
More natural, thank you.
You bet.
So it sounds good, mm-hmm. and we like the idea, but what are people finding as challenging in trying to implement this? Mm-hmm.
So the biggest challenges that we all face together, no matter what it is we're trying to change or what goal it is we're trying to reach, is our own thoughts. So our own way of thinking, our thought patterns, mm-hmm. are our own, and they construct the life we live, the day to day and the way we think. So what I work with people on is changing their thought patterns.
Oh, wow. Ooh.
Yeah, and research shows it takes 66 days on average to change a thought pattern.
Oh my goodness.
And that is a significant commitment for anyone mm-hmm. to make a change in your life. So, you know, I give people a lot of credit who are working hard at that because it is a daily intention.
Mm-hmm. Angela, I wish we had more time.
Yeah, this is great. I get to be here all day with you.
All right. We can find more information. She also has events and things online that you can take a look at.
Yes.
Thanks so much for
Thank
coming
you.
In. We'll be right back.